Hi, welcome to experiment number 6 in the robotics lab, and today we are going to use accelerometer as servo motor control with LCD display. For the objectives of this experiment, number 1 to control the angular displacement of the servo motor using the accelerometer, number 2 to display data in serial monitor and LCD display coming from the Arduino. For the equipment and materials, we need 1 personal computer, 1 Arduino microcontroller, 1 servo motor, 1 accelerometer. It can be ADXL345 or MPU6050, 160x2 LCD display, 1 USB cable, 1 power supply, 1 breadboard, and 1 set of connecting wires. For the introduction, an articulated arm is a robot with rotary joints, so it can be used for a wide variety of applications. In this experiment, a servo motor, a type of rotary motor, is used as an output for the accelerometer sensor. An accelerometer is an electromechanical device that will measure acceleration forces. These forces may be static, like the constant force of gravity, or could be dynamic, caused by moving or vibrating of the accelerometer. By measuring the amount of static acceleration due to gravity, you can find out the angle the device is tilted with respect to Earth. The purpose of the experiment is to control the angle of the servo motor using an accelerometer. The angle will be limited only from 0 to 180 degrees, since the servo motor only operates from 0 to 180 degrees. So the program will be created mainly in Arduino, and we will be mapping the values to achieve realistic mimicking of the accelerator movement. So the anchor projection will be shown on serial monitor and LCD display. Here in FreeSync, this is our circuit design. We can see the LCD display and the potentiometer for controlling the LCD's contrast or brightness, and both were connected identically from the previous video in experiment number 4, potentiometer as sensor. For the servo motor, the PWM pin or the yellow pin is connected to the 6th digital pin of the Arduino, red pin is connected to 5V power supply, and the black pin is connected to the ground. For the accelerometer, we will be using MPU6050. VCC pin is connected to 5V supply, ground pin is connected to ground, SCL pin is connected to A5 or analog pin 5 of the Arduino, and SDA pin is connected to A4 or analog pin 4 of the Arduino. Here in the schematic, we can see a more detailed version of our circuit design we made in the breadboard. GY1 is the accelerometer wherein the VCC pin is connected to 5V, ground pin is connected to ground, SCL is connected to A5 of Arduino, SDA is connected to A4. For the servo motor, pulse pin or PWM pin is connected to D6 PWM. Negative pin of servo motor is connected to ground, and positive pin of the servo motor is connected to 5V. And for the LCD display, VSS connected to ground, VDD to 5V. VO is connected to the second pin of the potentiometer. Second pin of the potentiometer is connected to 5V. And third pin of the potentiometer is connected to the ground. For the RS pin of LCD is connected to D12. Read and write pin is connected to ground. Enable pin is connected to D11. DB4 is connected to D5, DB5 is connected to D4, DB6 is connected to D3, and DB7 is connected to D2. For LED positive or anode of the LCD is connected to 5V, and LED negative or cathode is connected to the ground. Now let's create the code. Here in our code for the LCD display, we place our pin assignments. For the libraries, first we included MPU6050 header library. Second, Adafruit underscore sensor header library, so that MPU6050 will be used as a sensor. Then wire.header to establish a communication with MPU6050 and Arduino. Then we included servo library for the servo motor and liquid crystal header for the LCD display. Next, liquid crystal LCD in close parenthesis 12, 11, 5, 4, 3, 2. Those are the pin assignments for the LCD display. Then servo space servo, that will be the name for our servo motor. And Adafruit underscore MPU6050 space Greg underscore Axel. So the Greg underscore Axel will be the name for our accelerometer. Then for the voice setup, serial monitor setup, serial.begin 9600 for the baud rate. And for the LCD display setup, since we are using 16x2 LCD, LCD.begin and close parenthesis 16,2. Then for the servo motor, pin assignment, servo.attach and close parenthesis 6. Then for the wire setup, wire.begin. Then for the accelerometer setup, greg underscore axel.begin. There we will start the MPU6050 as sensor. Then servo.write, in close parenthesis 0, So we set the starting position of the servo motor to 0. Then for the accelerometer and gyroscope ranges setting, greg_axel dot set accelerometer range. We can set it to 2G, 4G, 8G, or 16G. Here we set 8G. Then for the set gyro range, we can set 250, 500, 1000, or 2000. For the range, we set 500. Then for the set filter bandwidth, we set 21Hz. Then we place a delay of 100ms. Then here in the void loop, we will get the new sensor events with the readings. Sensor_event_T, A, G, and temp. So those are the parameters that the accelerometer can read. Acceleration, G-force, and temperature. Then greg_axel.getEvent, in close parentheses, and A, and G, and temp. So whatever measurements read by the accelerometer will be kept here or categorized here. Then for the accelerometer, x, y, and z axis values, we declared three integer variables, xval, yval, and zval. So for the xval, a.acceleration.x. So whatever x value reading of the accelerometer will be the value of xval. Then for yval equals a.acceleration.y. So whatever reading of the accelerometer in y-axis will be the value of yval. Then for zval equals a.acceleration.c. So whatever z-axis values read by the accelerometer will be the value of zval. Wherein we will be using the value variable for mapping. So value equals map, yval, we will be using the value in the y-axis from negative 10 to 10 and be converted to 0 to 180 for the servo motor control. For the servo motor control, servo.write and close parenthesis value. So the servo motor control will be dependent on the result angle based on the mapping value. Now this is our code for the serial monitor. So we will show the value of x, y, and z and the servo angle in the serial monitor. And we will also show it using LCD display. So here's the code. We will also show x, y, and z and the angle. Then we replace delay 50ms for the stability of values. Then lcd.clear. Now let's compile and upload to test the circuit. Okay, tools, serial monitor. And here is our accelerometer. And we can control the servo motor by moving the accelerometer in its y-axis. Here. Y negative 9, angle is 9, then 7, negative 6, 36, negative 1, 8, 90, 0, 9, Y is 0, angle 90, then let's, Y is 5, angle is 135, then 6. For the Z value, we can increase it by, there, decrease. X, it also moves. For the servo motor, we control its angle using the y-axis read by the accelerometer. Using the accelerometer, we can control two another servo motors using the x-axis values and the z-axis values. Then for using two servos, we just added here in the breadboard diagram another servo motor wherein the PWM pin of the second servo is connected to the 9th digital pin of the Arduino. And the red pin of the second servo motor is connected to 5V power supply and the black pin is connected to RAM. Here in the schematic diagram, the servo motor is also added wherein the pulse pin is connected to D9 PWM, negative pin is connected to ground, and positive pin is connected to 5V power supply. Now let's create the code. For using two servos, we name our second servo servo_x and the first servo using the y-axis values servo_y. Then for the servo motor pin assignment, for the servo motor Y, it is attached to pin 6 of the Arduino. Then for servo_X, it is attached to 9 pin of the Arduino. Then for the accelerometer setup, so both servo motor will have a start position of 0. Then for the void loop, we declared another two variables, integer X value and integer Y value. Then for the X value, it will also use mapping, in close parenthesis, X val from negative 10 to 10. Which will be converted to 0 to 180 also. Then here's the code for the X servo motor, servo_x.write, X value. So whatever result here in the mapping code will be the value of the x value, and it will be responsible for controlling the x servo motor. Then servo.write, just the same a while ago. Then for the serial monitor, there. Now let's compile and upload. Now let's test the two servos. Tools, serial monitor, there. Now let's try. Mostly Y. Mostly X. Y. X. As you can see in the serial monitor, changes values. Since I only have two servo motors, if you have three, you can use the Z-axis values to control the third one. There.